Half-a-day students, I am Governor Lou Leon Guerrero. You all have been through a year of big changes. We've had to adapt and make big changes to keep our families and our island safe. But with change comes opportunity and a chance to try new things like PBS University. While Lieutenant Governor Josh Denori and I will continue to do our part to keep our island safe, you students have a part to play as well. Your part is to keep learning and to keep up with your lessons. That's why I am happy to see you here ready to learn with PBS University. PBS University is a way to bring a continuous educational curriculum to you while you stay safe at home during this time. To help you keep up with your studies, we asked our friends at PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education to put together this episode. Thank you for doing your part and have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education in conjunction with public school teachers. These lessons are created to provide both parents and students with a unique educational experience while helping students to continue learning at home. PBS University, next on PBS Guam.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Come along, let's sing a song, we'll have a great adventure. We'll have a great adventure.
Numbers,
letters,
science, things, all that we can do. Help you deal with how you feel, share with us too.
It's super cool and just like school,
our awesome learning adventures. So grab a friend, the fun will end, our awesome learning adventures. Awesome learning adventures.
Mugothin, boys and girls, did you know that Mugothin means hello in Yapese? Well, welcome back to PBS University. I'm Miss Lenata, your pre-K literacy teacher. For today, we're going to learn how to recognize the letters in our names. How cool is that? So what are letters? So if you remember from 2 episodes ago, we had talked about symbols. And a symbol is a drawing, an object, or a shape that represents an idea. So a letter is actually a type of symbol, because it represents the sound that it makes. So now we're gonna go ahead and meet some friends of ours that are going to help us in recognizing the letters in our names. This is Uriah. He's going to help us with our name puzzle activity for today. So for the name puzzle activity, you will need a pair of scissors, a marker, a half sheet of paper, and of course an adult, just in case you need them. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to write your name on the sheet of paper using the marker, and you're going to write it really big, but make sure that your name fits on the sheet of paper. This is where you might need an adult's help in spelling your name. So for the next step, you're going to draw lines in between each letter. Your lines can be squiggly, it can be zigzag, it can be straight, just as long as there's a line in between each letter. So for this next step, you're going to grab your scissors and cut along the line that you drew in between each letter. Be careful using the scissors and make sure there's an adult watching you during this step. After cutting out the first letter, Uriah realized that it was pretty hard to cut along the line, so he went ahead and asked for help. After cutting out your letters, you should have different pieces that make up your name. So you're gonna go ahead and mix up the letters that you just cut out, and then with the help of an adult, or if you can recognize the letters in your name alone, go ahead and piece the puzzle of your name back together, just the way Uriah is doing it. Well, I hope you enjoyed making your name puzzle with us today. We're going to go outside now and meet some new friends who are going to help us out with our next activity. Now, this is Anthony, and this is his little brother, Adrian. They're going to help us with the What's Your Name activity. So this is the What's Your Name workout activity. You're going to spell your name, and you're going to complete the workout associated with each of the letters. So if you have the letter A in your name, you're going to do 10 jumping jacks. If you have the letter B, you're going to do 5 push-ups. If you have the letter C, you're going to do 1 burpee. So you're going to continue with each letter and do the activity associated with the letter. The goal of this activity is to complete the exercises associated with the letters in your name. So Anthony's name is spelled A-N-T-H-O-N-Y. He's going to spell it out using the movements. So for the letter A, he has to do 10 jumping jacks. For the letter N, he has to do 10 jump ropes. For the letter T, he has to hold a plank for 10 seconds. For the letter H, he has to do 10 front lunges. Next, for the letter O, he has to do 10 Russian twists. Then for the letter N again, he has to do 10 jump ropes. And lastly, for the letter Y, he has to do 10 leg raises. Look at him go. Good job, Anthony. Next up is Adrian. His name is spelled A-D-R-I-A-N. Let's see what he can do. So for the letter A, Adrian's going to do 10 jumping jacks. For the letter D, he's going to do 10 front leg raises. For the letter R, he's going to do 10 side skaters. For the letter I, he's going to do 10 side lunges. Look at him go. Good job, Adrian. Then for the letter A, he's going to do 10 jumping jacks again. And then lastly, for the letter N, he's going to do 10 jump ropes. Good job, Adrian.
Well, that was certainly a workout. But I hope you had as much fun as we did in spelling your name using the different activities. So, before we end our class today, we need to say our I can statement one more time. So your I can statement for today was, I can recognize the letters that make up my name. So I hope you had fun and enjoyed our class today. Until next time, bye boys and girls.
Welcome back to PBS University. My name's Mrs. Perez, and today we're going to be learning some pre-K math. But before we get started, I wanted to have a tasty treat. One of my favorite treats is ice cream, and I have my ice cream cone and my scooper. Now, we just need to figure out what flavor I'm gonna have. Let's open it up. What? Wait a minute. This isn't ice cream. These are shapes. Hey, it's a good thing that there were shapes inside of this container instead of ice cream, because today we're going to be recognizing and identifying 2D shapes. My friend Riley is waiting in Omo's room right now, and she's gonna help us learn. So let's go. Today in Omo's room, our friend Riley is going to help us recognize 2D shapes with shape drawings. Riley's gonna draw some shapes with lines, some straight lines like this one. Ooh, 1, 2, 3, 4 straight lines. Hey, Riley drew a square. That's an awesome square, Riley. Now she's drawing a shape with curvy lines. We all know this one. She drew a heart. How pretty. Love it. Now what shape is she going to draw? Ooh, another, whoa, big curvy line. It's a nice round circle. Now this one has some straight lines. Whoa, it has 3 straight lines, which makes it a triangle. Now she's drawing another shape with more straight lines. What could it be? Oh, I see what it is. It's a rectangle. Thanks for playing and learning with us in Omo's room. Now that we know some of our 2D shapes, my friend Leo the Lobster is here to play a game with us. Say hi. Hi, Leo.
Hi, Mrs. Paris. And hello, friends. Today, we're going to play a super awesome game. It's called a shape hunt. How do we play that? Well, you go around your house and look for things in any sort of shape, like a circle, or maybe a rectangle, or a heart, or even a square. Oh my goodness, there are shapes all around us. Let's see if you can find them.
Hi, Leo. My name is Natalie, and today I found a cookie cutter, which is a star. I found my play money, which is a rectangle. And I found my jewelry box, which is a heart. Bye, Leo.
Hi, Leo. My name is Lou. I found a dinosaur egg that's an oval, a Rubik's cube that's a square, and a block that is a rectangle. Bye, Leo.
Hi, Leo. My name is Adeline, and I found a glass bowl that is a circle. I found an oval that is a rock. I found a box that is a square.
Leo, my name is Frankie, and I found this triangle, and it's a magnet tile. Found this heart at the table. I found this basketball, and it's a circle. Thank you.
Thanks for sharing with us, and now we're gonna have some friends making shapes with their bodies.
Our friends Skylar and Natalia are going to make a shape using their bodies. Let's see what shape they're going to make. Can you see it? I do. It's a
diamond! Awesome! Now, Riley and Maya are going to make a different shape. Ooh, it looks tall. I wonder what it is. Do you see it? I see it now. It's a rectangle. Nice. Aw, look at our little friend Stella. She's making a shape all by herself. Do you see it? I wonder what it is. It's a triangle. So cute, Stella. Now all our friends made one big shape. What shape do you see? It's a star. Awesome job, friends. Now it's your turn to grab a friend or a neighbor and create some shapes with your bodies.
Friends, it's time to go. But before we do, let's feed our shape monster. Ready? Shape, monster, munch, munch, munch. I want the circle for my lunch. Which of these two shapes is a circle? If you said it's this one, you are absolutely right. Ready? Munch! Shapes are everywhere. So remember to go out and look for them. And also remember that playing is learning. So keep on playing. Bye, friends.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome. Buenas and hafa day. Or in Korean, we would welcome people by saying, Annyeonghaseyo. Well, welcome to Pre-K Science. My name is Mr. Diego, and today we're going to talk about science. We love science. But to help us figure out what we're going to learn and talk about today, let's look in our treasure box to see what we will learn in Pre-K Science today. Let's check it out. Let me unlock the treasure box real quick and open it. Okay. Wow. So I see what looks like tiger paws. Okay. Okay. That's a clue. That's a clue. Wow. I also see a bee in here. That's another clue. I see a word. And our word, A-N-I-M-A-L-S. That spells animals. We are going to talk about animals. Now, I believe there are lots of different types of animals. There are six types of animals. One, two, three, four, five, six. The six types are mammals, reptiles, fish, amphibians, invertebrates, and last but not least, birds. Awesome, awesome. I'm excited to learn about all of these animals. Now, the first two types of animals we will learn today are mammals and reptiles. I can't wait to learn about them. I have some friends today that are going to help us learn more about mammals and reptiles. They're going to teach us some cool facts about them. Stay tuned.
I'm here with Talia, and she's going to help us learn about mammals. She's going to teach us three things. The first thing is...
I'm Talia, and the first thing is mammals have fur or hair. The second thing is mammals feed their babies with milk. Then the third thing is mammals breathe like this.
Awesome. Talia, do you have a favorite mammal?
Yes, my favorite mammal is a dog.
So dogs are her favorite type of mammal. Let's head back to class. Cool things about mammals are they feed their young or their babies with milk. Who doesn't love some milk? Delicious. Milk, right? We love milk even when we grow up. Put some milk in our cereal. Mammal. Love milk. I can't wait to eat cereal after this episode. But another cool thing about mammals is they're warm-blooded. Warm-blooded? What does that mean? Now, mammals are warm-blooded animals. What does that mean? That means the inside of mammals stays the same. Doesn't get too hot or too cold. It stays the same always, right? That's what warm-blooded. All right, boys and girls, I have a special treat for you. Do you know what it is? We're gonna visit someone, a mammal, but not a mammal like me. We're gonna visit a different type of mammal. It's a goat. Are you ready? We're gonna have to go outside, so.
All right, here we are outside. Hello, boys and girls. This is Rocky. He's a goat. He's a mammal. I thought I'd feed him some leaves to give him a peace offering. Awesome. He seems to have loved it. Loved it. All right. This was fun. Let's head back to class. We learned a lot about mammals. Now let's talk about
reptiles. Mr. Diego brought a very special guest. His name is Kyle. Kyle the crocodile. Now, Kyle, because we are not socially distancing, I'm going to have to put my mask on. I hope that's okay. That's okay, Mr. Diego. Do I need a mask? No, Kyle, you don't need a mask because you're a stuffed animal. Awesome. So, Kyle, can you teach me and the kids at home about reptiles?
Sure. Do you have any questions for me?
I have some questions. One question would be, what kind of animals are reptiles?
Oh, that's a really good question. The different types of reptiles are snakes, turtles, lizards, alligators, and crocodiles like me.
Awesome. That's pretty cool.
Now let's ask a friend to help us learn about reptiles.
Hi, I'm here with Haven. And she's going to tell us about reptiles today. She's going to give us three awesome facts. And the first one is?
They are covered in scales.
Scales! Whoa! What else?
They lay eggs.
They do lay eggs. And the third one?
They have a backbone.
They have a backbone, just like Micah. Wave, Micah! Awesome!
That was awesome. Let's get back to class.
To help us learn more about mammals and reptiles, let's play a game. You're gonna see Mr. Diego, but he's going to be using only his hand.
Okay, so I see the words mammals and reptiles, and these are my hands. Of course, you know that. So, let's see if something is a mammal or a reptile. If they have live births, are they a mammal or reptile? Do you know? They're mammals! Of course they are. Let's try this next question. If they are born from an egg, are they mammals or reptiles? They are, wait for it, reptiles! Of course we knew.
Well, we'll see you later, Kyle. Reptiles like Kyle are born from an egg, and mammals like Mr. Diego, we are born live. We have live births. Another cool thing is reptiles are cold-blooded and mammals are warm-blooded. Next episodes, we will learn more about different types of animals like fish and amphibians. How cool is that? Stay tuned. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hafiday students, welcome to PBS University. My name is John Fernandez, and I'm the superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. These PBS University lessons are made to help you to continue learning. The teachers here prepared fun lessons on science, character education, math, English, and more, and they made it for you, the students of Guam. We're very grateful to them for their instruction. We're also thankful for you students, parents, and guardians who are watching. Remember, stay safe and healthy, and we'll see you soon in the next school year. Thank you.
Kasalele, boys and girls. That means hello in Pohnpeian. I'm Mrs. Pacheco, your pre-K teacher for fun with fine arts. And today, we're gonna do some magic. Have you ever done magic before? Well, today, we're gonna be creating some new colors. How do you think we're gonna do that? Maybe. Let's go and take a look at what kind of materials we got at the store. Let's take off this plastic first. So, here are some of the materials we got at the store. Down here we've got our paint mixer, right here. We've got some, what color is this? That's right, it's yellow. How about this? Do you remember what color this is? Yes, it's blue, ultra blue paint. How about this color? That's right, it's red. But what about this one? I think this one's my favorite. What color is this? That's right, it's white. I'm so excited to use these paints. How about you? Over here, we've got our paint mixer. Here we can hold our paint like this, put our thumb through it, so it makes it easier to hold, easier to get all of our paint when we're making beautiful art. Do you see any more art supplies? Oh, right. I almost forgot. We need our art pad right here to paint on, right? We can't paint on anything like our walls or our couch or our doors. We have to paint on our art pad like this one. Let's open her up. I almost forgot one more thing. Something we need when we're using paint to make art. What art supply do you think it is? Of course, we need some. What are these? They're paint brushes. I've got so many colors too. Are you ready to paint with me? Awesome. Let's open up our art pad. Beautiful. So this paper is called canvas paper. Can you say canvas paper? Canvas paper, good job. So this canvas paper is really nice and thick so that I can paint and it won't go through the pages. Are we ready to paint? Let's do it. I'm gonna take my handy dandy paint mixer. It looks a little bit like this. It's made of plastic. It looks kind of like a spatula for pie, right? It's gonna help us mix the paint without getting any on our brush yet. Let's do it. What color should we start with first? This is called pearl white paint. Kind of looks a little bit shiny. Let's put some ultra blue here in the corner. Let's put some cadmium red here on the right side. And last, let's put our yellow down here on the right. Let's see if we can make some painting magic. Are you ready? Me too. Okay, where did I put my paint mixer? Oh, here it is. What color should we do magic with first? Let's try mixing some red and some yellow. Are you ready? Let's put some red on our spatula. Now, let's put some yellow in. Whoop. What color do you think it's gonna make? It looks like ketchup and mustard. I'm getting so hungry. Do you ever mix ketchup and mustard? What color does it make? I think we need a little bit more yellow. Let's put some more. Do you see what color that is? What color does that look like? Wow, that looks like a nice orange color. Isn't that pretty? Now, what color do you think we should mix together? I think we should mix blue and red. What color is that? That's purple. Amazing what you can do by mixing colors. What color should we mix now? I think we should mix blue and yellow. What color do you think we're gonna make? Oh my goodness, look at this magic that's happening. What color is this? That's right, it's green. We made that. Let's try mixing red and white. What color do you see? That's right, it's pink. Amazing color magic, friends.
Wasn't that so much fun making art with magic? I can't wait to make and see more art with you. Until next time, my friends, spread love, not germs.
Kamusta? That's a greeting in Tagalog, a language in the Philippines that means, how are you? I'm Miss Desiree, your social and emotional learning teacher for pre-K, and today, we're going to be learning about how to set goals. No, not goals like in soccer, but close. So, what type of goals am I talking about then?
A goal is something that you want to do in the future. Let me explain what I mean. Is there something you really want to do, but can't quite do it yet?
I want to score a soccer ball.
My name is Evan Gale, and I want to dunk like Sean Marion.
Hi, my name is Natalie. I'm going to do good in kindergarten.
I'm Daryl.
He wants to be
a runner.
Hi, my name is Leanne, and I want to learn how to ride a bike without train wheels.
Hi, my name is Ryan, and I want to play football like my brother.
Hi, my name is Tammy, and I want to play basketball like my mom.
Hi, my name is Liam, and I want to get better at surfing.
Everyone has dreams. Let's start small. Setting a goal gives us a target that we want to reach. Setting smaller goals as part of a larger goal makes it easier to follow the steps to reaching our big goal so that we are not trying to do everything at once. Let's go through some steps on how to set our goal.
Step 1. Pick something you want to do. Something you want to achieve given a certain amount of time.
Step 2. Make a plan. Writing our goal down is a great motivator. It feels more real when you can see it, and it will serve as a reminder.
There is a lot of work in step 2. It is where we have to put in all the small steps in order to reach our big goal. So, if Mandy wants to score a goal during her soccer season, what does she need to do in order to make that happen?
Well, going to practice is a good place to start.
During practice, Mandy will be able to develop and improve the skills that she needs in order to score a goal. Each task is going to be worked, but each one will reward you closer to your goal. And when we succeed in these smaller goals, it motivates us to keep working towards our long-term goal. If we try to reach our goal alone, it's easy to give up. Other people help encourage us and help us find easier ways to complete our task. And working together towards a goal is more fun. Most goals require hard work and practice. Don't give up when you get frustrated. I know that it can be discouraging. When you feel like giving up, take a step back and think about all your accomplishments so far. Is it really worth giving up all your progress? Remember to reward each mini goal. It will motivate you to keep going to achieve your big goal. So, that brings us to our step 3. Reflect. What did you learn while you were practicing? And what will you work on tomorrow?
Let's sing a song about it.
Bimmy Boo! The Goal Song.
Let's practice setting goals now. Let me show you how. This goal setting form helps you set goals and get better at making positive choices. I'll set a goal for myself to show you how. I'm going to start writing my name at the top, followed by the date. Then, I think about the positive choice I want to practice and circle it. Today, I want to practice listening and thinking. This will help me understand what others are telling me. Next, I make a plan on how I'm going to meet my goal. I draw a picture of myself practicing the goal. Here is a picture of me listening to Mandy, so I can understand what she is telling me. So here, you can see that Mandy is asking to go play outside. And I have a thought bubble that shows I'm thinking about what Mandy is saying. At the end of the day, I think about my goal. I ask myself, did I practice listening and thinking? The last step is think about tomorrow's goal. Will I practice the same positive choice or pick a new one? All right, boys and girls, I hope those steps were helpful for you. Email me at this address to get a copy of that worksheet so that you can start working on your own goals. We have a lot of time to practice during the summer, so have fun. I know that you'll do great things. Remember, be safe, be respectful, be responsible.
Hafaday and yakwe, my dikiki friends. Hafaday in Chamorro means hello, and yakwe in Marshallese means hello as well. I'm Senora Loretta, and welcome to Chamorro.
Yakwe, hafaday, hello, Senora Loretta.
Oh, hi, Pina. Can you say hafaday and yakwe to our PBS University friends?
Hafaday and yakwe! Senora Loretta, what are you doing today?
Well, Pina, I was just about to share with our friends about different types of homes on our island.
Who? There are different types of homes?
Yes, Pina. Houses come in different sizes, shapes, and material to build these homes. A house is built to protect us from heat, rain, and storms. Pina, did you know long time ago, before houses were built, people used to live in caves?
Oh, wow! Senora Loretta, I didn't know that.
There are still many caves around the island, and some have pictures or images on the caves of the wall.
How do you say cave in Chamorro?
Lidzeng. 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 Lidzeng.
What is that?
Well, Pina, as time went on, people started to look around and they came up with great ideas of how to build a house using natural material.
What is that?
Well, Pina, our ancestors built a laddie stone house long time ago. They used wood, palm leaves like pandanus and coconut leaves that they wove together, and carved limestones to build a laddie.
Wow, that's cool. How do you say laddie stone house in Chamorro?
Guma atu laddie. Guma atu laddie. Laddie stone house. Pina, try it out.
I want my friends to say it with me. Okay, friends, try out with me. Guma atu laddie.
Gov malik famagun.
Senora, what other kinds of houses are on our island?
Did you know that there are homes made of wood? We call this kind of house in Chamorro guma hadzu. Guma hadzu. Wooden house. Pina and friends, can you say guma hadzu?
Guma hadzu.
Gov malik.
Senora Loretta? Senora Loretta, I live in a treehouse. A guma hadzu sounds like my house.
You're right, Pina, but we also call a treehouse guma trunku. Guma trunku. Treehouse.
Wow, that's so cool. Guma trunku. My house is called a guma trunku.
When I was little, my uncles got together and they had built a guma trunku for me, my brothers, my sisters, and cousins. We used to play and pretend that we all lived together. We had so much fun.
So cool! Guma trunku. I'm going to share that with my parents and my sister, Mana.
Okay, Pina. Let's review the different kinds of homes we talked about. The first home we talked about is a cave.
Lidzeng. Lidzeng.
Good job. The next house that we learned was Guma atu lati. Guma atu lati. Lati stone house. The next home we learned was Guma hadu. Guma hadu. Wooden house. And Pina's house, Guma trunku. Guma trunku. A tree house. Okay, boys and girls, here's a short Chamoru jingle about saying goodbye until next time.
Gunyama he babo. Jambo, everyone, and saubon. Jambo is how you say hello in Swahili. Saubon is how you say hello in Zulu. Both are African languages used in a particular Disney movie. Do you guys know what movie that is? Well, that's what we're going to talk about in today's Fast Fun Fact with me, Boop, Mr. Ernest Ochoco. Now, the movie that we're talking about is Disney's, the 1994 animated classic, The Lion King, one of my very favorite movies. Now, there are some interesting things about this movie. Did you know that it took about 2.5 years, maybe 3 years, to make the entire movie? The movie was about an hour and a half, and it took so long to make it. Yeah, about that long. Isn't that cool? The stampede by itself. Do you remember that stampede where little Simba was in the canyon and he was scared because the stampede was happening and he was like, oh my gosh, they're gonna step on me, they're gonna die. Help, somebody help me. Well, that stampede took about 2.5 years by itself to make, right? That's such a long time. Now, the other thing is that the entire movie used about 1 million drawings. 1 million. It's a lot of drawings. My hand would be so freaking tired. But it's not only one person who was drawing the whole thing. There was about 600 people working on the animation. That's right. So the other thing about The Lion King is that it was supposed to be called The King of the Jungle. But lions don't live in jungles. They live in like the grasslands and the savanna and open woodland areas, not the jungle. So that was one of the things that they had to change. So they changed it to The Lion King. And the other thing is, The Lion King made it to Broadway and is the third longest running show in Broadway history with over 9,000 performances. And that's it for your Fast Fun Fact with me, Mr. Ernest Ochoco. Ingunyama nengwinamabala. Ingunyama nengwinamabala. Bye.
Hafiday students, I'm Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. For more than a year now, you all have continued to wash your hands and watch your distance from others, and you've done a really great job wearing your masks. We know your parents and guardians have helped you to make these changes to keep yourself and your community safe. As Governor Leon Guerrero said, we are happy you are here. We want you to continue to learn and sharpen your skills with the help of PBS University. This program is the result of a collaborative effort. We couldn't do it alone. I'd like to thank the teachers and support staff of the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam for their work and their commitment to our students. I'd also like to thank you, students, for participating at home. To your parents, I'd like to thank you for taking an active role in your child's education. We are all eager to return to a time when all of us can share and study together in person. Until then, we hope you learn something new from this PBS University instruction.